Hi children, good morning. Welcome to e-learning resource. Before starting the class, hold your hands and pray. Oh Lord, keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me in the shadow of your wings. Amen. In the last class, you have learned four kinds of landforms. That is, mountains, plateaus, plains, and valleys. In this second part, we can discuss about deltas, deserts, islands, peninsulas, rivers, isthmus, and straits. Deltas. The place where a river flows into the sea is called the river mouth or estuary. Estuary means river mouth. When the land area at the mouth of the river is at the sea level, the flow of water is slow. Children, listen carefully. The place where a river flows into the sea is called the river mouth or estuary. When the land area at the mouth of the river is at the sea level, the flow of water is slow. As a result, the debris brought by the river is deposited at the river mouth. Debris means pieces of remains, waste that comes from the water. As a result, the waste brought by the river is deposited at the river mouth. The flow of the river is broken and it divides into small branches called distributaries. Distributaries means small rivers. The place where a river flows into the sea is called the river mouth or estuary. When the land area at the mouth of the river is at the sea level, the flow of water is slow. As a result, the debris brought by the river is deposited at the river mouth. The flow of the river is broken and it divides into small branches called distributaries. This area is called delta. It has a triangular shape. The world's largest delta, the Sundarbans, is at the mouth of the river Ganga. The world's largest delta is Sundarbans. It is at the mouth of the river Ganga. Deserts. A desert is an area of land which has very little water. Rainfall is very scanty here. Scanty means less. Very less rainfall is in desert. Sometimes there is no rain at all for years. They are very hot and dry places. The temperature is very high. As a result, deserts support very little life. We can't find big trees or animals there. They are mostly sandy areas. Sandy means covered with sands. A desert is an area of land which has very little water and very less rainfall. The temperature is very high. There is no big trees or animals. They are mostly sandy areas. The Sahara Desert in Africa is the largest desert in the world. The Thar Desert or the Great Indian Desert is situated in Rajasthan. Some places in the desert where water is available are called oases. There we find plants like date palms. Some people and animals live around oases. The places in the desert where water is available are called oases. We can find plants like date palms. And some people and animals live around oases. The camel is used as a means of transport in the desert. Islands. An island is a landmass surrounded by water on all sides. Islands are of various sizes. An island is a landmass surrounded by water on all sides. Greenland is the largest island in the world. Sri Lanka and the Andamans are smaller islands. The largest island in the world is Greenland. Peninsulas. A peninsula is a land area surrounded by water on three sides. A peninsula is a land area surrounded by water on three sides. The southern part of India is a peninsula. It is called the Indian Peninsula. It has the Arabian Sea on the west, the Indian Ocean on the south, and the Bay of Bengal on the east. A peninsula is a land area surrounded by water on three sides. Rivers. You know that rivers are very important. Rivers are the lifelines of the world. Lifelines means life saving. The things we depend for our life. So, the rivers are the lifelines of the world. A river is a large flow of water across land. A river originates in the mountains and flows downwards and joins a sea or ocean. A river is a large flow of water across land. The Amazon in South America is the largest river in the world. The Nile is the longest river. Other famous rivers are the Ganga and the Brahmaputra in India, the Danube in Europe, the Mississippi in North America, and the Congo in Africa. Rivers are very important. They provide water for our daily needs and also for our crops. Crops means our agriculture. Larger rivers help us to transport things and people on ships and boats. Rivers are very important. They provide water for our daily needs and also for our crops. Many civilizations flourished along the banks of rivers. Civilization means a society or culture in ancient period. The Indus Valley civilization on the banks of the Indus. Indus is the name of a river. The Egyptian civilization on the banks of the Nile and the Mesopotamian civilization on the banks of the Tigris and Euphrates were some of the important civilizations. Many civilizations flourished along the banks of rivers. Flourished means developed. Many civilizations developed along the banks of rivers. Isthmus and straits. An isthmus is a narrow strip of land that connects two large areas of land. An isthmus is a narrow strip of land that connects two large areas of land. North America and South America were connected by an isthmus. Now it is broken by the Panama Canal. In between North America and South America, it is Panama Canal, and the strip is broken. A strait is a narrow strip of water that connects two seas or large water bodies. A strait is a narrow strip of water that connects two seas or large water bodies. The Park Strait between India and Sri Lanka is an example. An isthmus is a narrow strip of land that connects two large areas of land, and a strait is a narrow strip of water that connects two seas or large water bodies. I hope you all understood the second part of the fourth chapter, landforms. I will send you the notes after this video. Now it is time for today's home assignment. Write two examples for each of the following in your social notebook. Two examples for each of the following in your social notebook. Mountain, plateau, peninsula, desert, island. Okay, children, we can conclude the class here and meet in the next class. Bye-bye. Thank you.